Welcome to Minutes by Minute. I'm Elgin Nichols.
And I'm Dave Kenny.
And we're here to talk about what goes on in the village, the township, and all those government entities that affect your life by making all those little regulations and ordinances out there.
And these are the people that, you've elected. And whether you live in the township of Oxford or Addison or the village of Leonard, the village of Oxford, these are the people that are making decisions that directly affect you, whether you attend these meetings to voice your opinion or not. So that's what our program's about, mostly.
Yeah, and it can come back and bite you, you know right where.
Okay? Oh, well.
So pay attention. We find a little humor in this thing as we go along because there's always humor in government. And much of what we say is a disclaimer, but much of what we say is close to the truth.
Which 50% that is, you'll have to decide for yourself.
Right. Let's start, and we'll talk about the Addison Township Trustees meeting, a special meeting that they held.
Oh.
And they had that January 5th.
Okay.
And Bruce Pearson, of course, is the township supervisor and heads up as a chairperson for this.
Usually special meetings are single purpose, aren't they?
They are. And this was a single purpose. And the purpose was they're building a new building.
Uh-huh.
At least reconstructing the existing one that they're in right now and for the township hall and offices. So
have they actually started?
They haven't actually started yet. As a matter of fact, they're going through plans, site plans, evaluations,
okay,
and cost, what this project is actually going to turn out to be. And that's the interesting thing we'll talk about down the line here.
Now, they do have a project manager, too, don't they?
Yeah. Now, well, David Gason is the company that was approved, to go ahead with this and sign a contract with the township, to do this reconstruction work, including the parking lot and a building to house the sheriff's department over in that area. And the sheriff's department alone holds right now 700 some odd square feet, and they're going to actually intend to double that to 1,500 square feet.
Get a little breathing room.
Right. Well, one of the board members says, "Whoa, how come they have to double it? Isn't there something there? We need to look at. If they're only using 700 now, why do they have to go to 1,500?
Because they're probably sitting in each other's laps.
They probably are. Well, I think they take a number and they go in one by one.
I see. Now serving.
And they give up the number when they go out the door, something along that line. But they're also looking for having, what do they call them, covers for vehicles. Not garages, but...
I know what you're talking about. It's a
covered
parking space.
Yeah, those things, yes.
There is a name for them,
it
eludes me at the moment.
You know what? It'll come to me before this program is over.
It'll come to you at 3 o'clock in the morning, I know.
It probably will. Anyway, so these folks, they brought three other people with them. David Gason, the guy in charge of this project, and the individual or company that signed the contract. And he said, "We are here to gather information and input more than anything." He said, "We're looking for your feedback."
Right.
Okay. And then they commenced to go through the various items that they want to change, within this layout.
Under the existing structure.
Under the existing structure.
Okay.
They currently have roughly 10,200 square feet of space in there, and it's going to come out pretty close to that same thing, but they have to remove the existing roof. They have to do a lot of reconstructive things in order to bring this into, into a quality building.
And not look like a Lego.
Right. And among those things, they said they would add another 563 square feet for storage also, because it seems like they have a problem with storage. And I don't know if it's the police officers that come in
that
by one. They don't know what to do with them.
No. No, is that for like archives and stuff like that?
It is.
Okay.
Yep.
Does this place have a basement?
This place has no basement.
Okay.
Mm-mm.
Not the existing building or the new one?
The existing building or the new one.
Okay.
That I'm aware of. Anyway, that's still under plans. Who knows? It could have a basement.
No.
This could turn into a 3-4-story building. I have no idea. Depends on cost. And we'll talk about that as we get down the line here. They said it will seat approximately 67 people in the community room.
Is that the community room, or is that the room where the township board meets?
Nope, that's the community room.
Okay.
And that's a separate room, and that'll be roughly 1,000 square feet. And board member says, "Well, wait a minute. I think we have 1,200 square feet or 1,500 square feet. Now, why are we going 1,000 square feet?" Well, the reason why we're going to 1,000 square feet is because
it's smaller, friendlier.
No. You don't get it. Anyway, the current operation that they have has a kitchen in it.
Ah.
And they said that they very seldom ever use the kitchen. And it takes up X amount of space.
They miss less words.
Right. So they said also by eliminating the kitchen, you don't have to deal with the health department.
Oh.
And when they come in, you know, they inspect everything. Yeah. Pick up, how did that get under there?
Yeah.
You get fined if you don't fix that.
They look really close at kitchens, don't they?
They do. Yeah. Hey, your faucet's dripping. Another $800 faucet will fix that. Right. So anyway, so they want to eliminate that. And so that's one of the reasons why it's got a reduction in space. But they said, hey, look at this. You're going to gain additional storage space also. You're going to need a place for put the chairs and those kind of things, you know, when people...
The designer giveth and the designer taketh away.
And it works out pretty good in this case. So, but that's kind of the original concept that they had anyway when they went into
this. What does a storage place smell like? Scrambled eggs. I don't know.
I don't know. But it won't smell that way for long.
Right.
Anyway... they presented the site plan, which is open for review yet, not really approved, you know, by the Planning Commission. It's strictly up for conjecture at this point. And they talked about the office walls and everything that were in there. And they spent a lot of time, you know, talking about offices. They said that there's glass in the windows and that kind of thing. And they went through and all the doors. And we won't, you know, if you want to see more, you can go to occtv.org, and you will find the actual meeting out there. That's OCC.
All the excruciating details.
Yep. All the details. We're just giving you the happy details right now. Right? Happy. But anyway, so they said that Sheriff is looking for roughly about an additional 800 square feet, which they said, well, what about the equipment inside the Sheriff's office? I understand that they're going to need new equipment. And Bruce Pearson said, well, like office equipment, it's not a problem because we get that from Oakland County. And actually for our facility too, Oakland County has a place.
That's right. It is the Oakland County Sheriff.
Yep, it is. So he said that will be provided. And he said any technical equipment that they need for police operations, he said that'll come out of their budget. Has nothing to do, you know,
Will be compatible with whatever is there in Oakland County.
Mm-hmm. And the township. Right.
Right.
They said, well, another thing that comes into play here is the amount of sound proofing that we do, you know, throughout the building. They pointed out at certain areas that there were sound proofing, you know, that was going to be done for the office areas, conference rooms, and that kind of thing.
Oh, that's good.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds like you're doing a pretty thorough job.
Right. They said, now the boardroom, what are we going to do for the boardroom? We're going to raise...
the dais?
Yeah. Are they going to raise it?
I don't know.
Well,
did you say raise R-A-I-S-E or R-A-Z-E?
No, R-A-I-S-E. Raise. With that raise, we'll be back right after this with more. Take off your hat, throw it in the corner. Take off your hat, throw it in the corner. Take off your hat, throw it in the corner. I don't see why you stay a little longer. I'm talking about
congratulations, OCTV, as the 2014 winner of the American Legion's Best Electronic Media Award, symbolizing your efforts to provide meaningful coverage of veterans issues and patriotic activities, as well as the American Legion.
Welcome back to Minutes by Minute. I'm Elgin Nichols.
And I'm Dave Kenny.
And we're just talking about raising things up.
Not burning them down.
Not burning them down.
As in raise.
Right. And so they said, well, we probably want to see the board members at a higher level. If you're seating a chair down below, you won't be able to see them if they're just sitting at a lower level. So we should put, you know, a riser up there.
It's either that or create theater seating for the people.
I don't think
which would be cheaper.
I don't think they have the money for that. And so then it comes down to it, and Lori Fisher, who's the treasurer, says, well, how much is this going to cost, and how many square feet are we talking about? They said, well, we're talking, looking at roughly 1,500 and some odd square feet.
Is this completely rebuilding the whole platform for the dais, or just extending the one that's there?
No, they're going to change some things that are there, and they're going to add a little addition, which is about 500 square feet, okay, roughly. But they're looking at, the contract read $156 a square foot, roughly, what this building is going to cost. And that's what they agreed upon, which included electrical, the heating plant, and, of course, the construction and materials.
But this dais thing is a little extra.
Well, they expect to pay a little bit more for the addition, which was about 500 square feet. They expect to pay that. But Lori says, well, we've been talking about a lot of things here, and the budget shows $1.5 million. How much is it going to cost, according to your plan here and all the things that we've talked about? And guess what?
I says, they came in under.
$2.3 million.
Wait a minute, hold it.
Lori says, what? $2.3 million?
Hey, for government overruns, that's not much.
Pauline Bennett says, now, wait a minute. Why is it so high? And they said, well, the cost of the labor has gone up since you did this. The cost of materials have gone up. And she says, but you only signed the contract 5 months ago. She says, how could it go up that much? He says, and Bruce Pearson says, well, how much did it actually go up? He says, well, the labor, and the materials. And he says, well, about 5%. Bruce figures it out. And he says, well, that's hardly $800,000 more. he says.
So what percent did it go up?
Well, it went up 5% for the labor and materials. But the whole thing went up a lot because it went up $800,000 over the proposed budget.
Can they cover it?
No, they can't cover it.
They don't have any little secret purse back there? Petty cash?
Well, here's the deal. Pauline Bennett then whips out the contract and gave it to one of the board members who read the contract word for word. And by the way, your signature's at the bottom of this. You agreed to it. He says, now, okay.
And it doesn't say the price is adjustable.
No, here's what they said. They said, well, we can take the siding off and put some different kind of siding on. We can put different insulation in. We can remove the windows in the offices inside. We can take some walls out. In other words, you can strip the building for $800,000. And Pauline Bennett says, well, now wait a minute. This building is almost the same size as the one we have now.
How much?
And we're going to strip everything out.
How much of that increase in cost is due to design changes?
Well, they're claiming everything has to do with design and additional materials that they have to use in the design. By the way, this project also includes the parking lot that they're going to be doing. And in the contract, I think it does cover the parking lot, but I don't think it's specific as to what they were doing. They were doing greenery and all kinds of things. And they said, when we do the parking lot, you may want to consider moving the fire department to another location. Fire chief jumped up and he says, whoa! Wait a minute. He says, no. He says,
those are my toys.
They're my toys and go on home. Anyway, no, he says, actually, the fire department where it's at right now is in an ideal location to access our residents. He says, it's centralized. He said, it's in a perfect location. Move it? No, I don't think so.
So this wasn't part of the original plan.
Right. This wasn't part of the original plan. So this, and he says right away, and protecting himself.
This comes under the title of, wait, there's more.
Wait, there's more. But he's
only in those ads, you're getting something for nothing.
Right. Well, the contractor, he's trying to protect himself here, and he says, well, I didn't say you really have to move it. It's just one of the considerations you could do. And she says, oh, okay. So he sat down, But anyway, he got a little excited when they were talking about
it. But still ready to jump up to the podium.
Still ready to jump up the podium.
Right.
So anyway, they were looking at kind of a college-type approach, with the greenery and the walks and all this kind of thing, leading to the door of the administrative
building.
Crystal
Palace. No.
Right. And so anyway, Lori Fisher, she says... Turns turns to Bruce Pearson and says, hey, is there a way we can get out of this contract? Something along that line.
Well, wait a minute. I would think that the builder would be the one that says that.
No. The builder, then he started to
skate. The builder's got a contract he signed for a given price.
Actually, the builder, then he says, oh, no, wait a minute. He says, you know, we can scale this down, you know, to fit what we need. And he says, we can talk about it then.
Now that we've dangled all the candy in front of you,
right.
Now you decide which ones you want to
you
take away.
You say what you want to do. Uh-huh. So anyway, it's kind of an interesting thing going on over there in Addison Township, don't you think?
Yes, indeed you do.
Pretty enjoyable. Well, there are more coming, by the way, folks. We'll fill you in, certainly on minute by minute, as to what's going on over there.
Not quite a torches and pitchfork meeting, but very interesting.
Yeah, very interesting. I'm surprised there weren't more people out in the audience, you know,
well,
for this meeting.
It probably didn't have advance notice as to what the subject was going to be.
But even special meetings are open to the public.
Oh, sure.
So I don't know what happened. Actually,
well, you post there's minimum amount of days that you're supposed to post these things
days
for.
5 days in advance, I think.
And
the,
of course,
7 days.
It has to be in a location where people would see that and their everyday lives, but they don't.
Right. You post it in the middle of the highway. That way. No, can't do
on
that.
The big boy sign. Oh,
but,
there's no more.
You know,
boy.
Since we're talking about Addison, since we're talking about Addison Township, let's talk about Addison Township Parks and Rec.
Parks and Rec.
Yeah. Now I get a kick out of those guys.
I'm sure you do. You like that pond, don't you?
No. I mean, these are fun people.
Okay.
On this board, you have Joe Schnurr and his wife Pat serves on this board, and Charlie Percheshinen, or something like the Percheshinen. I really massacred it today. But anyway,
the Finnish people are with you.
Perinchian?
What?
Perinchian? Something like that. Last name, Charlie.
Where is
really
it?
Nice guy, really smart guy. Has a good feel for mechanics, good planning, mindset. And they just have a very kind of comfy, at home type thing going on, chit chat.
They play well together.
They do. They do a very good job. And they get things done.
Good.
Which is interesting. they said they first of all read last month's minutes. And
as they are required to do.
As they were required to do. And they went over the bills, a whole $32.86 in bills. You know, so that was covered. They said, is there any old business? Well, there's a parking lot we need to work on. There's a deck we need to build. And they went through all that kind of stuff. They need
but
to trim the trails, got brush and
but
got
not
bears
now.
Are fighting the rush.
But not now when it's 0 degrees out, folks.
Right, exactly. And we'll talk more about that and the bears when we come back right after this.
Hi, everybody. I'm Terry Stiles.
Hi, everybody. I'm Bill Service, and I'm the producer of Our Community Access. Terry and I started our show 8 years ago to bring our community into your living rooms.
Our Community Access is a show born from the rich diversity of our community, and we want to brag about it and the people creating that diversity.
Over the year, we've been from fox hunts to beekeeping and right in your own backyard.
We welcome new businesses, chamber fashion, senior hobbies, class reunions, and much, much more.
We've covered all our celebrations from Leonard Strawberry Festival to our premier Lone Ranger Parade.
But there's still more avenues that we plan on going on.
So watch our Community Access at 9:30 and 5:30 every day, and you have a great, great week.
Welcome back to Minutes by Minute. I'm Elgin Nichols.
And I'm Dave Kenny.
And we are talking about the Addison Township Parks and Recreation. And Joe Schnurr is the chairperson. And they were talking about last month's bills and things like that.
I hear it was really high.
Oh, $32 and some odd cents.
Astounding.
It was, yeah.
People would beg for those kind of bills.
They would. And they talked about trimming the trail of brush because the bears are complaining. Too much brush.
I think the bears are hibernating right now at 0 degrees.
Well, they're still out there yet because, you know, it just turned cold for a couple days ago.
Oh, okay.
And before that, it was fairly nice out. Bears are still stomping around, knocking the brush over. Anyway, complaints.
They do have bears?
They have a drop box where the bears just fill out a form and they drop it in next to the new restroom. By the way, they did put new doors on the restrooms.
You got
there,
pretty so. Creative with those minutes, didn't you?
So that's what happens. That's what's going on over there in Addison, folks. Got to tell you. It's a fun area. Lake George Let me see. Oh, yeah, they got to cut some trees for the new dock over there. But they're not going to do it till spring. They decided
good
to wait.
Good choice.
Good idea, yep. And also a tractor. They were talking about buying a tractor. And so they're looking into the cost of the tractor, that kind of thing.
Brand new one or a used one?
Well, they're looking at new, I think, at this point. But they're pretty expensive. They're looking for a brush hog, you know, again for the bears.
Oh.
They got to brush the trail.
Got your basic car, and then you got your options.
You do, yeah. And they probably want power steering and all this kind of, I don't know. Right. I don't think they do because they're pretty frugal over there. So they'll find a way to get what
brush
they want.
Brush hogs notwithstanding.
No. The hogs want to run anyway when they see brush.
They chase the bears.
They do. They chase the bears. Anyway, right now, they say, well, how many bills, what kind of bills do we have this month? And they said, we have none. Really? Have no bills? Okay, that's good. Have any old business? Oh, the trail and the cabin, from the cabin to the northeast of the watershed, west, needs to be, you know, brush hogged and cleaned out. Right now there's an old lumber trail that goes in there, and they want to make it a regular trail. Let me see, handicap fishing
dock. How big is that park area anyhow?
Oh, it's pretty big.
Like how many acres?
I want to say 60, 80.
Oh, that's
acres.
A good chunk.
Yeah, it's a good
chunk. That's a good chunk.
Yeah, it's pretty good size. Anyway, the dock that they're looking at for...
The pond?
No.
Okay.
No, this is going to be not Perch Lake. What's the other lake over there?
Salmon Lake. I don't know.
No, not Salmon. Yeah. Yeah, Perch Pond is one
of them. Guppy Lake, no.
No. They're going to put a portage on, though, on Perch Pond.
Oh.
That's the one where the fish were dying off. And they put minnows in there, you know. They put 1,500 minnows.
Was it because of the portageon?
No.
Because of the lack of the portageon?
No. It used to be a portageon there before, but they moved it.
I see.
And then the fish died? Back. No, they got...
And then the fish died?
No, the fish didn't die. They actually, they put something like 1,500 or 2,500 little minnows in there.
I remember that?
We talked about that at the last...
What happened to the minnows?
Oh, they're still in there. They're alive.
Oh, now they're going to put big fish in there?
Yeah, in the spring.
I see.
Put big fish in there.
And all the minnows will get in a little cluster like goldfish in
an
Oscar tank.
Yeah, and I think they put something in the water to take care of the...
Algae.
Algae. And not algae. It's a bacteria, but like an algae.
Oh,
That make these fish turn brown or spotted
on
the back. So they're going to try that again,
And as we
too.
Discussed before,
oats.
That spotting is not ick. Yeah. It's something else.
Yeah, they put oats in there, I think it is.
Oats.
Yeah. Anyway. A watershed east, they said that they need to trim that trail. They said that they used rangers the last time, and they have something like 20 rangers, and they said that...
And rangers are volunteers, aren't
they? They're volunteers. They really wanted, I believe it's 23 rangers originally as a goal.
That's really nice you got that many people out there.
Well, they don't.
They don't?
No. According to...
Well, you led me down that little primrose path.
Yes, according to Charlie, we have these, but they don't show up.
Oh.
And Pat Schnur says, yeah, I know. She says, we have usually 12 or 14, you know, show up. And Joe Schnur, he says, as chairman, he says, well, he says, you know, they're supposed to attend one meeting each quarter in order to remain a ranger. He says, and if they don't meet that criteria, they're not a ranger.
And so how many people aren't rangers anymore?
Well, that's what Charlie said. Charlie says, well, there's a bunch of them that aren't going to be rangers. We need to look at that and see what we can do, you know, about...
Well, we don't want to throw the baby out with the dishwater here. Wait a minute.
Right. We want to boost that. In other words, we got
to... We want to retain these guys.
Well...
What do we do?
It gives new credence to Lone Ranger.
Oh.
There's a few of them out there.
Where are my people?
Where are my people? Yeah. Okay. So anyway, they said the other thing they need to do is put new rule signs out, you know, various locations.
Mm.
And so that's a project that they're going to be working on. They said that, 18 park rangers right now is what they have, supposedly on the list.
Oh, ones that have attended meetings?
Yep.
Or is that on paper?
That's on paper.
Oh.
Yeah. Ones that are actually there are like 12. At the last showing, they had about 12, I think, showed up.
Out of a potential of 20?
Yep.
Okay.
So, anyway, the tractor, they said, about the tractor. We'll be working on the tractor, and purchasing one, but we need a place to store it that's more secure.
Right? The shed.
Well, the shed has a door on it right now, but you blow on it, and the door falls open. So they said, well, we need a new latching system and a new door system, you know, before we get a tractor. That would be more important. So anyway, that's pretty much.
It would seem that the door is in that condition. Maybe the shed should be redone too.
Right. But there's a lot of things going on out there in Addison Township. And I'll tell you what, if you folks are looking to have fun, as ranger, you will have fun working alongside these people too. But they have picnics and all kinds of things.
And they give you a little whistle for the bears.
Yeah.
And little bells.
Bears have a louder whistle, but if you hear that whistle, you run for the little outhouse. No, that's the bear's place.
Or what's the old saying? Just be sure you're faster than your friend.
You got it. Yeah, right. You bring a slow friend along. The other thing I want to talk about today is the Oxford Board of Education. And I'm only going to touch on that briefly because they had their first session January 7th. And I'm running out of time. And there are four new members that were sworn in. Mike Schwag, Joyce Brazington, Mark Stepick, and Kim Schumacher. They're all sworn in.
Oh. Did they go to the process of electing a chairman?
They did. They elected president.
President. Well,
and that person that was elected was Jim Reese.
Was he an old member or a new member?
He's an old member.
Okay.
Well, not that old. He's younger than you.
A senior member.
See, there you got it. Okay, and vice president was Carol Mitchell.
And she's new.
Yeah. No. She's not new.
She's not.
But she's not as old as you either.
Well, thanks. Not many people are.
All right. Secretary was Mark Stepick. He's new. And treasurer was Dan Alessandra. I believe is
whatever you say, sir.
Dan. Yep. Our man Dan. Spokesperson is a person who speaks for the Board of Education when there's things about newspaper questions, that kind of thing, releases to the media.
Who is that?
That would be Mark Stepick.
Okay.
Was put into that position. And there's a person that they want to put in charge of rules and of order, you know, for the meetings.
See. Yeah.
And that's Mike Swag.
Would that be a parliamentarian?
It is. Mike Swag. Okay. And
that's a complicated job when you read the Robert's Rules of Order.
Well, Robert's Rules, according to Dr. Skilling, don't necessarily apply 100% in this. And, of course, one of the board members says, well, wait a minute now. The charter says that you'll use the Robert Rules. And he says, well, that doesn't apply to everything. There's parliamentary order.
Except by this document that we're presenting to you.
Right.
By the way, the other elephant in the room is the election of a new superintendent.
Yes, and that will be coming up in the next session that we do on Minutes by Minute. And meantime, what's coming up quick?
Okay, we do have meetings. On 1/13 at 6:30, the Village of Oxford Council, of which you're no longer a member. And also on 1/13 at 7 o'clock, the Oxford Township Parks and Rec. And 1/14 at 7 o'clock, Oxford Township Board of Trustees. And on 1/15 at 7 o'clock, the Village of Oxford Planning Commission. And on that same day at 4:30, NOTA, North Oakland Transportation Authority, will be meeting at the Oxford Vets Hall. And on 1/19, the Village of Oxford DDA will be meeting at 6 o'clock. That's Downtown Development Authority. And at on 1/20 at 7 o'clock, the Village of Oxford Planning Commission.
Lots going on. And you know what? Lots have been going on behind us. And all the noise that you hear in the background, folks, that's from the exercise firm that we have down the road here.
I thought it was a Tarzan movie.
No, it's about two buildings down, but
the jungle drums are beating, folks.
Yeah, they are. In the meantime, we'll catch you next time on Minutes by Minute. I'm Elgin Nichols.
And I'm Dave Kenny.
Catch you then.